Alcoholism.
Alcoholism. So the actual answer is anorexia.
Probably anorexia.
I'll say alcoholism.
Alcoholism. Okay, so the actual answer is anorexia.
Yeah. Anorexia.
Anorexia. Okay.
That alcoholism.
One. Alcoholism. Okay, so the actual answer is anorexia.
Really? Anorexia, it just kind of slowly destroys your organs because they're not getting the nutrients that they need. I don't know a lot about anorexia in particular, but eating disorders, I have some friends that have battled with those. I know a little bit about those.
Probably a mixture of society pressure, like feeling the need to be skinny. It might have genetic factors as well, I don't know.
Okay, perfect.
I don't know. Mental illness, definitely something mental. Probably lots of factors that go into it. Get your shopping on at the mall, max your credit cards. You don't have to choose, buy it all. So they like you.
Do they like you? My name is Taylor Valdez. I am 22 years old. Hi Taylor, thanks for being with us here today. So my first question is, why do you believe, or who do you believe suffers most from anorexia, or who can potentially be at risk for it?
The most important thing about eating disorders, and especially anorexia, eating disorders do not discriminate against gender, race, age, anything. Anybody can get an eating disorder. Get up, you don't have to change a single thing. You don't have to try. You don't have to try. You don't have to try.
Why do you believe anorexia has the highest mortality rate?
As a human being, you need food to survive. So I believe that the mortality rate comes from that, the fact that it's a basic necessity to eat food, and the fact that it is a psychiatric illness and a mental illness. Both those together kind of contribute into that and make it really, really, really hard to treat.
See yourself as big or overweight?
Depends who I compared it to. When I compared it to models and magazines, I saw myself bigger. Now when I look at myself, people always ask me, do you realize how thin you are? Yeah. But when you look in the mirror, you see a 2D image of yourself. Everybody that sees a picture of themselves, they don't see the 3D image that slenderizes you. It's just a fact.
So you think that society does play a role in anorexia?
Absolutely. The ideal body shape has changed so much over time. I mean, there's like a YouTube video of the 20s and the 30s and the 40s, and it goes from like being really voluptuous and curvy to thin to like a medium to a thin upper half and curvy bottom. Like it goes all over the place. So I'm not really sure where this really rail thin ideal body shape came from, but wherever it came from, I do believe that it plays a big part into it when somebody embarks on a diet. Your pre disposed to an eating disorder, but you need an environmental trigger. That's why nowadays society will hand that right over. When I looked at myself in a mirror and said, oh, I'm fat, or oh, I'm chunky, or oh, I need to lose weight. Did I really believe that? Sometimes, but the majority of the time, no. When I said I'm fat, it really meant I'm sad. I'm hurting.
How would you describe anorexia, just using one word?
Horrifying.